Hey everyone, this is Scott from CertMedia.com, and in this video I'm going to be covering a free plugin called A3 Lazy Load. I haven't talked a lot about lazy loading on this channel before, and I feel like I'm going to address how lazy loading works and how this plugin works in particular. So lazy loading is the process of rewriting basically the source attribute of an image or an iframe or a video, and then when you scroll down the page via JavaScript, it gets replaced with the actual source URL of the image. So what this does is it reduces the amount of requests and the page weights on your initial page load. So for example, and this is a staging site for a redesign for my homepage that I was working on, we are going to go ahead and publish all these posts that I have in the trash can, and I'm going to show you how this works. When you lazy load a resource, you're basically telling the browser it doesn't need to download this until it reaches the point to which it can render it. So as we could see, and we're just going to go to the homepage, we have images like this image item right here. On the initial page load, only the items that are above, so everything in the initial viewport down to this text, should be what's rendered. This image, if it existed, would also render. But this image doesn't need to be downloaded until it begins to enter viewport. This is particularly useful if you're on a larger website where you have a lot of images. For instance, on my own website, and this is the live site where I push this design live, When I load it up, as you can see, I have many images, and you saw a bit of a loading icon for these ones. As you scroll down, the images begin to render in. A3 Lazy Load allows this to happen. What it does is it says to the browser, you don't need to download this resource, and then as it begins to scroll, it replaces the data source attribute with the correct source for the resource. So your page weight goes down and your request count goes down, and this helps improve the load speed, particularly for mobile devices. So A3 Lazy Load makes this incredibly easy, and we're gonna go through it, and I'm gonna show you the optimal way to configure it and to let you know some of the pitfalls you may run into. So first off, the plugin global settings, these don't really do all that much. You can just choose to open up the display box, which will show and enable all of the boxes to be enabled, and then you could choose to clean up on deletion, which basically just says when you delete the plugin, it will delete all of its data from the database, which is optimal. I would check this on. Typically, if you delete a plugin, you don't want to keep the settings laying around. Lazy load activation allows you to turn lazy loading on. This activates the actual plugin. If you're trying to debug and you uncheck this option, it will completely disable the functionality. Under lazy loading for images, this is where you get the to enable and disable specific image types that get lazy loaded. So post thumbnails, image in widgets, images in the content, gravatars, and then no script support isn't a type of lazy load. It adds a no script attribute that it works when a browser has lazy loading, or rather JavaScript, disabled, so that way images can still be rendered. But also for crawlers like Google, it can read it. Google, while it does render JavaScript, typically it does a first pass of the page where it only checks the HTML, and then it'll do another check at a later date to do a full render. This just makes sure that your images are properly indexed and avoids any SEO concerns that you may have by adding the no script support. Now, you have the ability to exclude images. What this does is allows you to include a class for the images to not be lazy loaded. So what you'll do is you'll go to your website, and let's just say you don't ever want this image type to be lazy loaded. So you look for some type of class. This is a background image, so there's not going to be one. But let's say we have this image right here, and we look to see if the image has a class. This particular image does not have an associated class because the class name needs to be included on the image source, not on the above attributes. So if I wanted to exclude this from lazy load, I now need to edit it and add a class for it to be bypassed from lazy load. So I'll have to add this attribute to the class name, or if it has an existing class name, I can provide it here. And we're basically just telling it that it doesn't need to be lazy loaded, and it's because this is an advertisement, we want it to render right away for whoever our partner is that we're working on. So we just scroll down, in this case, on this theme, and it has an option to provide it with an extra class name. So I'm just going to click skip lazy as the class. Then I'm adding, depending on your own theme, it may have a different way for you to do this. You'll have to consult with them, or if it's another thing that I've covered, it should have already been covered in the video. So if you look over here now, we now have the image class, and the skip lazy attribute was actually added onto the div class, which gotta love themes and their odd decisions, but the concept works the same. You add the class skip lazy to any image that you don't want to be lazy loaded, and it will not lazy load them. The horizontal scroll, what this does is it, if you have a gallery where you have a horizontal scroll, so sometimes if you use some kind of a slider, maybe you have a collection of logos that you're displaying, like through Owl Carousel, you could include this, the container class name or the IDs. So that way there's no weird interactions with it working. Under the lazy load videos and iframes, what this does is it will lazy load the most common videos, WordPress embeds, YouTube videos, Vimeo videos. What it will do is it won't download the video JS until after it comes into viewport. This helps a lot. While I do recommend that you host actual videos on something like YouTube, primarily to have good playback speed and for it to download quickly, the player itself is quite bulky. It's about 1 megabyte of JS. So by lazy loading the videos not in viewport, you can dramatically reduce the initial page weight and improve the render speed. If you've ever run a GC matrix test, for instance, and you see defer JS and it comes up with the YouTube embed JS, this is a one solution that you could look at resolving it. And you enable it, and it should work out of the box with the most common YouTube implementations, including video series, playlist, and the just single video. So long as it's in an iframe, it will work. You can exclude the exclude by URLs and page types. So if you want to exclude pages to not be lazy loaded, you can include a URL and the entire page will not be lazy loaded. So let's say you have your checkout page in WooCommerce, and you don't want any of the images that you're showing on there to be lazy loaded, you'll just include checkout, and now they will not be lazy loaded. You can choose to exclude it by page type as well, including different archive types. So say you don't want lazy loading on your post categories, this will disable it for all post categories. You typically don't need to do any of this. This is more of a debugging tool. So just keep this in mind. I wouldn't do this unless you have a real reason to do it. Under script load optimization, make sure this is checked to say footer. By loading in the footer, it's not going to be render blocking, which will improve your website's load time. Under WordPress mobile template plugins, if you're using WP Touch or MobilePress, you will need to make sure it's disabled because there are conflicts with it. WP Touch, if I recall, does have its own implementation of lazy loading, at least on some of the images. So you want to make sure that you're not lazy loading again, which could prevent the images from rendering. The effect in style allows you to choose the load in effect. The default is a spinner. There's also a fade in effect. Really, no matter which one you go with, it's personal preference. I prefer a fade in effect because it looks a lot more natural and cleaner. When you have a spinning icon though, it does give more feedback to the user to let them know that this image is being downloaded, it's just not quite ready yet. Whichever you go with, it's really your own call. You can choose a background color too, so that way you do have branding colors, which can work to your advantage, depending on how you're trying to style your website. These effects typically only last, at the most I normally see is a second, and that's for fairly large images. So it's really just personal preference and how you want it to look. The image load threshold, what this does is it increases the amount of pixels outside of viewport for the images to start being fetched. So if you notice that your images are taking a long time to download and you're waiting for the spinner or the fade in effect to go away and the actual image come in, what you can do is increase the threshold by a number of pixels. So what you'll do is say if you set it to 100, so on top of the initial threshold limit that the plugin has in place, this will add plus 100. So it'll be up to, let's just say the default is 300. Now it'll be 400 pixels outside of the viewport that images are starting to be downloaded. This allows you to have a more seamless interface. If you're a website that has a lot of images, but you still need to have some sort of lazy loading, increasing the threshold limit, while it can cause more images to be downloaded on the initial load, it will cause them to download faster, so that way the icon isn't staying there as long. You'll have to experiment. In most implementations where you have a fairly optimized website, you shouldn't need to mess around with this option, but if your websites are serving large images, like in a photography-based website, then you may need to increase the threshold so that way users are able to download the images faster. And then the final option is the Jetpack Site Accelerator. If you're using the Jetpack Site Accelerator for images, you need to check this option so that way those CDN images can be lazy loaded. By default, they are skipped. And this will only allow them to be lazy loaded so long as you have this option enabled. There's never any issues that I see with it. I think it's just some kind of weird hiccup with the device pixel.js and how this thing works. After you enable this option though, it should work without a problem. Really, A3 lazy loading is just a solid lazy load plugin. I never have any issues. It's not as dangerous as some of the other lazy load plugins. What I mean by dangerous is it is a lot less prone to issue. Some lazy load plugins are quite heavy-handed and they will lazy load every image and it will cause breakage. This plugin is very conservative, but it does do cover most images without breakage. If you have any questions about this plugin, please feel free to ask in the comments below. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching and goodbye.